I'm Sir Taptap, and welcome to Let's Play Onechanbara Z2 Chaos. If you copy this game, it's provided free of charge by Xseed Games. So this is a game that surprised me in lots of good ways and lots of bad ways. So let's just continue on. Actually, let's take a look at the menu here. The menu is very confusing. Coordinate is how you change your clothes. Battle setting is basically your equipment and store all in one. Options menu, pretty limited. One thing I would like is a faster camera movement option, and there isn't one. It is dual voiced, which is good. I'm not a big fan of the English dub. One thing I should mention early on, this game has sort of a Grindhouse B-movie or like exploitation film vibe to it, as you might have noticed from the cast of characters over here. I guess I'm not a huge fan of that. I don't know. A lot of people seem to appreciate the vibe the game gives through its story and voice acting a lot more than I did. I was expecting something more like Senran Kagura, which has a lot of humor in it and, you know, doesn't take itself too seriously, but actually has somewhat decent writing and good voice acting. Of course, the voice acting is all in Japanese in Senran Kagura, but you can tell the acting is good. Decent production value, actually very good production value considering what the budget must be. This game, really, really low budget, but what matters is this game, actually the combat is way better than it has any right to be. It's a character action game, and so it has lots of flashy moves, and there's a scoring system, you know, like any stylish action sort of game should have. And the game isn't difficult. I'm playing on hard, and you know, most things are pretty brainless. The difficulty in the game comes from scoring, so you want to, you know, let's see if I can actually show this off. I'm not super great at the game, but nope. Okay, there we go. I dropped it. So the basic combos you can get just by mashing, and you know, this is just me mashing square. But if you press with the right timing, if she'll ever stop this attack, you get this blue sparkle, and your attack is faster and does more damage. And if you get the full combo with the blue sparkles, you do an extra finisher that does crazy damage, and then you can do a tag team in to continue that combo. And you can do that like four times with four finishers, which is really cool, but also timing for that really picky. I can't reliably do a full combo. There's a item you can buy that makes those combos like impossibly easy, but only for one character at a time. So, well, here's a boss here. So as you notice, it has like sort of Musou-ish enemies that are really, really stupid, and you just sort of slash through them. This is kind of fine because it's just fun to wail on them, and there's a lot you can do with the combat. Like, let's take a look at the commands here. So like your basic combo is just mash the button, but then there's, you know, these delay, there's these delay attacks, there's these, you know, use up and triangle, there's like spin. I think you get one of these, right? You have different attacks if you do a little spin with the control stick. So you don't have to know all of the advanced stuff, especially to beat the game on the normal difficulty. The game is like super easy on medium. Like, as long as you, if you use checkpoints, which, you know, if you just, you know, click continue, very easy. I died 3 times almost entirely due to completely forgetting that the devil trigger drains your health, or because I didn't know you could restore your weapons. Like, let me show you that. When you use weapons, you get blood on them, and you can just press L1 to throw the blood off, and then it, you know, does full damage again. I honestly did not know that until the final boss fight. The game actually has great loading screen tips, which is good because the loading is like the worst part of the game. Everything takes too long to load. But honestly, that's the one technical issue I can complain about. The game is pretty much flawless 60 FPS. I've never noticed a drop in normal play. I've heard that some of the absolute most craziest mission mode things can lag it just a little bit. But for the most part, even with 4 player characters on screen and like 100 enemies, no frame drops, and so combat feels really nice due to that. But the load times are really quite bad. Like, I've never really seen something quite this bad on PS4, honestly. Not considering how little loads. You might have noticed the graphics are not particularly great. The character graphics are just fine. Character animations are fine. Enemies are, like, acceptable. My main problem is that the zombies are, like, 7 feet tall for some reason. And, the bosses are kind of... The bosses vary from okay to kind of decent. But the level graphics, like, it looks like I'm playing City Escape over here. The level graphics range from laughably bad to pretty okay. Like, not high budget okay, but considering the budget, some of them are okay. The interior spaces tend to look better. But generally speaking, you're just gonna have to accept that it's not gonna be a pretty game. So I guess I should show you some of the other characters. So, there's a lot of systems in the combat here. We've got our standard fighting game sort of EXE meter here that builds up. That's the blue bar you can see in the top left there. And once that fills, we can use this attack, or... Everyone has, I think, 3. I haven't unlocked all of them, though. There's a whole lot to unlock. It has the standard action game. You beat people up and you get their soul orbs, and then you buy new combos and new weapons. I'm pretty sure new weapons are just a straight damage increase and higher durability. You add combo... You add a number of button presses to every single combo and add some different moves through the combo thingy. What else is there? There's also... I mentioned briefly, there's a double trigger. Everyone looks stupid and ridiculous in their double trigger state. I guess... It's kind of hard to fault things in the game for being stupid, because I guess it's kind of supposed to be deliberately stupid in some ways. But, alright. And there's QTEs. All the QTEs are executed entirely through the touchpad, and it's surprisingly satisfying and really accurate. Like, I absolutely hate stupid... Oh, I died. That's what happens when you don't pay attention. The devil trigger thing drains your health. I probably should have healed or... switch characters earlier. What was I talking about? The QTEs are all really easy, all touchpad only. They're not as, you know, dramatic and great as anything in, you know, Bayonetta or anything, or God of War. But they're also not instant death upon fail or annoying or anything. You just, you know, you swipe in the direction it tells you to. It doesn't really get in your way. That's kind of just fine in my opinion. I kind of like the touchpad for that. My favorite use of the touchpad is still Binding of Isaac, using it for the map. It brings up the map and scrolls it all in a single action, and that's really nice. Use your super. So, bosses always have a QTE or two to defeat, as you might expect. The bosses are your main source of difficulty, other than, you know, scoring. Most of the bosses still aren't super active. So the QTEs are kind of basic. But the music is not entirely to my taste, but I mean, it fits the weird B-movie vibe. I saw somebody compare this to Lollipop Chainsaw, and the way I would describe it is Lollipop Chainsaw is a higher budget game relative to this. That is emulating a B-movie feel. This is a game with a B-movie budget that is also trying for that feel. So, Lollipop Chainsaw, I would say, has a considerably worse combat system, significantly better everything else than this game, but I would not replay... Well, I did not replay Lollipop Chainsaw because it just isn't very fun, aside from the, you know, crazy campiness, so it doesn't really have that replay value. This does, in my opinion. The combat is a lot more fun than you'd probably expect, and that's... I was expecting this game to be funny and to have kind of crappy combat. One annoyance here. The game locks you in these gates until you kill all the enemies, and fairly often you'll end up with one zombie that got caught on some object, and you have to go hunt his butt down, and that's why we couldn't exit the gate there. Fortunately, it doesn't affect your score. Time does not affect your score. Basically, you just want combos and to do those cool, you know, precise button timing things, and some other stuff to boost your score, like aerial attacks do that. Cool combos do that, just general long combos. That splatter thing gives you 200 extra points. I think just any time you kill something in your double trigger state does that. There were too many of them. So there's been a fair amount of character action this last year or so due to Bayonetta 2, both Devil May Cry remasters, but if you're still hungry for more character action stuff, this is surprisingly competent combat-wise. And there's also, so the game is very short, took about 4 hours to beat the story, but like any character action game, it's got, you know, higher difficulties that you're gonna unlock as you beat the game, and then, you know, you beat the game on difficulty number 2, and then you unlock difficulty number 3, and so on. And the story doesn't get in your way too much, so replaying isn't very annoying. As you might have heard, it does the voice through the controller gimmick, a la No More Heroes and stuff. I don't really mind that gimmick. Some people really dislike it. You can just turn off the speaker on the controller, I think. I'm not sure if... there's no option in-game to disable it. I'm not sure if it'll just be entirely mute, or if the voice will then go to the TV. I haven't bothered with that. I also keep forgetting to try out the Japanese voice. I'm sure the Japanese voices are fine. Some of the... I don't entirely like the feel of the the English voice acting. Some of the lines are very unenthusiastic, but I guess it kind of fits the B-movie feel. I don't know. It doesn't do too much for me, but it's not enough to, you know, make me not want to do the killing zombies part. Basically, it's a hard game to recommend, but I would say that if you think, you know, what you're seeing with all the combos and stuff looks fun, then I think you would enjoy it. It's, you know, pretty much what you see is what you get. You gotta be willing to overlook the graphics and stuff, and the lack of a story, which, I mean, I don't frankly consider either of those really important. If a game has a good enough story to justify its lack of gameplay, that's fine with me, but it's also fine with me if, you know, a game has gameplay that justifies its lack of story and all that, you know. It depends on what the game's doing, so we're gonna wanna... I'm still not used to throwing the blood off the weapon. When your weapon is too bloody, you get extra hit stop, and it just ends up really annoying to fight, and your attacks just take too long, and then enemies will get in and hit you while you're... like, you suffer from the hit stop, but you're, like, it doesn't actually stop time, so enemies can still hit you. It's kind of an interesting way to implement a durability system. I don't think it actually reduces your damage. I think it just, you know, makes you really slow and crappy. Oh, and I didn't show you, but there's a customization system where you can, you know, change your outfits. Like, if you don't like the, skimpy bikini thing here, you can give the bikini girls, like, this girl's outfit. Oh, and I love this. One of the unlocks you get is Sailor Moon's toast in your mouth, so you can just run around with toast, which is excellent. Oh, and there's a few poorly designed checkpoints in this game. I got lost for a few minutes here the first time. What you're supposed to do is go back here, and there's a gate here that's disappeared. It's kind of not obvious. Oh, this is obviously not the first game in the series. I have not played any of the earlier games in the series, so I think I'm missing some of the quote-unquote story stuff. Like, the game gives you a synopsis, and I mean, you shouldn't really be playing this for the story anyway, but I've heard that some, like, long-time players appreciate the uniqueness of the voice acting and stuff a lot more. So, I don't know. Also, I'm not entirely sure what the stars mean when you're getting combos and stuff. I've gotten, like, V rank, which is the highest rank, from just, like, one gold star, and sometimes not. It's just... it doesn't directly seem to correspond to your rank. Also, anything that is not V rank, which is the highest rank, they will complain at you for getting. Unless, like, V rank is the only rank that is even relevant. It's kind of funny. So we should probably use a healing item here. Oh, and there's items you can use. I almost never use any of them except the Cure Gem, which heals you, and the Chaos Gem, which permanently increases your health. I really wish it said permanently increases the user's max health, because I just completely ignore those for a while. And you can only hold 9, so you can potentially, like, lose out on them if you just ignore them and don't use them. Oh, and so you can switch in characters at any time, and once enough time has passed, your characters sort of recharge, and you can summon all up to all 4 at once. And so that's pretty cool. And they'll, you know, auto-attack with you or whatever. Oh, crap. I guess you do take some damage in hard mode, so that's nice. Did you just crash? Well, that's embarrassing. For the record, I've completed the game before and it never crashed on me. I guess it can, though. That's interesting. Hang on. Well, that was embarrassing. In the game's defense, I played it for like 5 or 6 hours already and it hasn't crashed before. Though I did have one issue in this like castle area where I killed all the enemies and the gate didn't lower and I had to do this like... Oh, I need to show you the chase attack. Let me show you that. I had to do the chase attack and switch characters to like wall climb and then get up to a higher level and then I just continued the area normally and... That was kind of embarrassing. It wasn't entirely game-breaking, but it was... It looked like it was for a minute. Well, many minutes. So... But that and the bug we just got are the only bugs I've actually seen so far. Not sure how common that is. I do like that the PS4 has a report bug, or like a report crash feature. I'm not sure how many developers actually... look at that or change anything, but, so, I forgot to show this, or at least talk about this. Chase, like, lets you force your enemies around, or, you know, hit them up into an air combo. Chase is really fun. In fact, it's one of my favorite parts of the combat, except it's not very useful against bosses, and, more useful in more open areas here. It's also useful if you want to get away, like, someone hurt me. Thank you. So if you want to get away, I said away, and heal, oh right, the characters. So there's two of the characters are vampires, this one and this one. And so when the vampires are hurt, they can just heal themselves like this. But if you get hurt while you're healing, you lose that whole gray portion that is healable. The other characters don't have that, but what they do have is they have a better dodge and counter system. Like, everyone can do this dodge, but... Oh, come on. Come on, you stupid Musou enemies. Well, you can do this dodge and... There we go. Dodge and counter, which is pretty cool. And I love the slow-mo, like, dismemberment things that some attacks get. I'm not entirely sure what triggers that, but Aya here... seems to do that the most often. And so there's a lot of interesting stuff in how to keep your score high. One interesting trick is that dodging resets the timeout on your combo, so you can just dodge roll around until you can get another combo hit in. But we're just gonna leave the story. Honestly, you don't need to see the story. It's like silly, incredibly simple B-movie stuff. There's a bad vampire. We're gonna kill her, then eventually you kill her, and things are kind of good somehow. But mission mode is available from the start and unlocks a bunch of cosmetic items. Like, every one I've beaten so far has given a cosmetic item. You have these specific missions, like only dash attacks. This one is very annoying because dash attacks are terrible. You get... A lot of them are, like, use specific attacks to defeat things. 6 ogres. It's probably that boss we fought earlier, the big purple guy. So yeah, there's quite a lot to do, and some of the outfits are kind of funny, like the toast one is the only particularly good one I've gotten. What else have I got? You can... It's sort of like Senran Kagura's thing, where you can put the accessories anywhere on the body. It's like, oh, those visors are obviously cosmetic items too. So you can put like sunglasses on people's feet. and basically any stupid thing you want to do. Loading is definitely the worst part of the game. It's not always super terrible, but when you're trying to like do some of the crazier challenges, like get all V ranks on a mission, or do like certain super hard or easy fail missions, then the loading time can be fairly annoying. The normal game time, as long as you get like check your phone or something, it's not really a huge deal. Where's the ogre? Ah, yes, this guy. So these like DBZ guys, these guys like shoot lasers and crap, and they're pretty annoying. Alright. The one problem with people's supers is that there's usually one super that's worth using and the others kind of suck. Like for Kagura, she's got one that like clones her and lets you double your attacks, and that's great for both damage and score, so I don't know why you would use anything but that. And so I don't, unless I accidentally, you know, forget to switch which one I'm using. Stop it. Ironically, I mostly use chase to get away from enemies, unless I want to, you know, isolate a specific enemy. But you can also use it to rush into danger as well as out of it. There's a fair amount of different bosses. The bosses range from really stupid to big walking, like, target practice to somewhat difficult. Nothing's super, you know, tactical. Mostly just, you know, beat stuff up. Oh, also when you're in Devil Trigger mode, you're... Oh, crap. Well, you die a lot faster, for one thing. Your super meter rises automatically. Yeah, that's why these guys are annoying. They shoot this frickin' laser. So I think one of my very few story mode deaths is due to these guys, because I got stuck in a room with one and just kept hitting with the laser as I was trying to beat up other stuff. It just was very rude. Generally, mission modes are very easy to get the V rank on, because like in a lot of them, only certain attacks do damage, so you can just spam combos. The scoring system's fairly exploitable. Like, bosses have to be killed by QTEs, so any boss you can pretty much farm for an infinite combo. So for any chapter with a boss, you can pretty much guarantee a V rank if you really want to. It's funny enough, it's actually the missions with the very few enemies where it's hardest to get a V rank, because then you really have to do actually good stuff, like good combos and stuff. Oh crap. This is one of those crappy supers I was talking about. Also, sound design not too great. That attack looks a lot cooler than it sounds and a lot cooler than it actually is, because it doesn't do much damage. Her rocket punch thing is actually way, way better. Also, while I was playing this game under the impression that you could not refresh your weapons, I noticed the chainsaw takes damage a lot faster than anything else, so I thought she was just the absolute worst character. She's not my favorite character, Kagura is, but dang it. But she's not too bad. You just have to wipe off the chainsaw a bit more often than other stuff. Oh wow, that wasn't even a V-Rank. See, I guess you need full gold stars on that one to get a V-Rank. But yeah, the game is pretty decent. I don't want to say mindless fun, but it's surprisingly decent character action combat. Let's see, you earn stupid unlockable clothing by beating those missions. So, if you need some more character action in your life, this is surprisingly decent at that. Don't buy it for story or, frankly, humor. It's not very good at those, but I enjoyed it, just not at all for the reason I thought I would, and I guess that's fine. But yeah, this is Onechanbara Z2 Chaos, PlayStation 4 only. I keep forgetting to say freaking platforms. You can Google, you can find out platforms. Yeah, that is this game. Hopefully you don't crash like I did. I can't even remember the last time I had something crash on my own, this was recording.